So in this video, we are going to explore the Meetings tab. Previously, we checked the Users tab. Let's go into the Meetings and see what's in there. So these are the Meetings policies. Again, they're pretty much default, and if you want, you can create your own or modify one. These are all of the already set up on out for you. So if you go into one, it shows you there will be same across the board with let's go back and show you. So this is the Gullibone policy. If you click one by one on each of them, they are all kind of same in the interface. It's just one or two is off or on, and then they named it differently. So, and you say it's not a custom policy, meaning that these are the default one. This is the global, site-wide, organization-wide, and everything is on, everything is off. If we, for example, if I go here, and you see this one is off, and this one is off, and if I go back, and let's go back, everything is on. We see everything is on, right? And it's grayed out. I cannot change it. Okay, if I go and everything is off, and you see everything is off, and again, everything is grayed out. So it's exactly the same. It's just that these default policies, and you will notice on across board on Office 365, the policies are exactly the same. It's just one or two on and off, and then that's what you get to change or choose. And this is the kiosk policy, meaning that if you have a kiosk set up somewhere, this will be, you can apply it to that one. So let's go to the first one and see what's in there. These are the general settings for meeting policies, like allow meet now in channel. I am not sure, like, if it's the is it a talk about the meet function in the Teams software, or it's the meet now that is from Google, because Google likes it for, Microsoft is pushing Teams, phasing out Skype, pushing Teams. It's a direct competitor to Zoom or Google's Meet now. Do you want the Outlook add-in, meaning that Outlook will have an add-in for the Teams? Do you want that or not? And, you know, give your user functionality from within Outlook. Channel meetings, scheduling. Do you want that users channels? If you remember that we have groups and then as teams, not groups, apologies, they call it teams. And within teams, you have different channels. So do you want channels meetings or not that they can schedule? Or scheduling private meetings, meaning some people, they want to, it's a private meeting between two managers or three managers or team, something like that. Audio and video. Do you want transcription? Transcription is the one that that whatever they're saying, it's being written at the bottom of the screen. Cloud recording. Yes, you can record everything and save it on the cloud. IP video, internet protocol video. Do you allow it or not? And media bitrate. That what's the bitrate for it to be used. Content sharing. What do you want? When they're sharing screen, how you want it to be shared? Do you want this whole screen to be shared or part of the screen? So it says entire single application disabled. So with this one, what will happen is that they get to choose the application. And if that application comes up on screen, the other user will see the. If they toggle between another one, for example, it's Teams screen or within Team, it's Microsoft Word or Office product, they get to see that. But as soon as somebody clicks on the Google Chrome and you see it shows up, the Google Chrome, they will not be able to see. Like while I'm doing this, you can see all my whole screen. But with this set to single application in Teams, what will happen is you will only see that single application. And if we click here, then user get the option to have an option to to select which application they want to share in Teams meetings, and you can disable it if you don't want the screen sharing mode. It is good, it should be done, and it's a lot. Let me give you an example. This is screen sharing. It's a pretty neat tool that without having the, if your user is good, like smart enough, you don't have to have the control of their computer. You can just verbally guide them through, and you know, you can just see and tell them, hey, go there, go here, do this, do that, and you can actually see their screen. I had this call today. The IT department lady was working with her employee and about VPN, and they were using Zoom, and she could see her screen, and she was asking me questions about VPN, and I was like, nah, we do. That's up to you, lady. You gotta set it up. Got this out of my scope of support. So other than this is again RDB, remote desktop. So do you want to give a request control? Yes. So it's happening inside here. An external participant. So external participant that's not within your organization. Using Teams, do you want them to control? It could be an outside vendor. Based on your need, you can turn this off or on. Right now it's off, and that's a security feature, that's why. PowerPoint sharing, yes, you can share from a whiteboard. I saw it in here, right there. So I want to explore it, but not within now. We'll do that, we'll get to that later on. And then allow shared notes. Notes are like whatever you've been writing. If you see MS Notes, then you can share them through here. And if there was an app, I think we were in apps. Oh, that was the when we were doing the Office 365 series. There was apps that we saw we can share. So participant and guest. Let any anonymous people start a meeting. Anonymous, like you don't know who it is. They just ping you. You want that to be on and off, yeah. For you can do that if you are providing service, like we are an ISP, so we don't want to know our customer to authenticate before they are able to ping us. It's just they ping us, they tell us what's the problem, then we ask them question like, what's your account number, what's your address, let us pull your account. In that case, we want this on. So it's just an example. Within a tightly organization, you may not want this one. Automatically admit people. Do you want it? Yes, everybody will be. Allow dial in users to bypass the lobby. So dial in is, I think, over VPN who dial in. That's my guess. It's grayed out, so we can't do anything about it. Let's see what it says. This can be set when, okay, everyone in your organization, now it's not grayed out anymore. So, yep, dial in is the one, the people that are from a remote location, like your homes, and they use the VPN connection, they get authenticated by their RADS server, and then do you want them to be joined? Meet now in private meeting. So I should see what's meet now in private meeting. Let me find out actually. Meet now Teams. Okay, that's not the Google one. It is the Microsoft Team. Meet now means that you can click and then your cameras and all that will come go live, and the other party gets to accept it. If accept, they start the meeting, they don't have to schedule it. It's just like back in the old days when you had messengers and you could, you know, request somebody to have video chat with you. Live captions, again, if you want to do captioning, organizer can override and allow chat in meetings. Do you want like some people to type? And it's a neat feature. I like it, especially when I'm in Zoom. it's you are not disrupting the person who is speaking or giving notes, but you can whatever is in your mind and you want to give an input, you can write in there so others they can listen to the person and they can see your message as well and they can get back to you. So this is pretty much what about the policies is, and you see meeting settings. So let's go. Actually, this video is getting long. I'm gonna wrap this video here, and I will create another video on the meeting settings and everything else. So if this video has helped you, please rate, comment, subscribe, and share. And I see you in the next one.